بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. This is an English summary. It's just in a translation of the Majlis of Hazrat Mawlana Qamru Zama Sahab Damat Barakatuhum, which took place on Tuesday, the 26th of Rabi'ul Awwal 1443, corresponding with the English date 2nd of November 2021. This Majlis took place after the Ishraq Salat at Baytul Azkar, the residence of Hazrat Wala Damat Barakatuhum. Hazrat Wala starts off by quoting the ayat of the Quran Majid, Ya ayyatuhan nafsul mutma'inna. Irji'i ila rabbiki radiyatan mardiyya fadkhuli fi ibadi wadkhuli jannati. Thereafter, Hazrat Wala goes on to say that I have this kitab on taqdeer in front of me. Hazrat Tanwi rahimahullah went to Makkah Mukarrama to go and spend time in the company of Hazrat Haji Imdadullah rahimahullah. At that time, now look at the trust, the faith and the confidence this Shaykh, Hazrat Haji Imdadullah, has in his disciple and his murid. He says, Ashraf Ali, I want you to translate this kitab. It will be of tremendous benefit to the people. So Hazrat Tanwi rahimahullah goes on and he translates this particular kitab. And this is the kitab that we are reading, the Talim, or we're having today's majlis from. Sheikh Iskandari rahimahullah goes on to say, that person whose mind and intelligent becomes complete and his nur is vast, then from the side of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he would have sukoon. Sukoon would come down and descend upon him. His nafs would not be restless anymore. It would become peaceful and contented. And he would have complete trust and faith in Musabbibul Asbab, the creator of the means, Allah Rabbul Izzat. So the nafs becomes mutma'in and calm and contented. And in front of the hukam and the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it becomes completely subservient. And it would not walk beyond what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants. And he would be now helped by the nur from the unseen. And instead of making plans and schemes and doing this and that, he would be right in front of taqdeer and accept that. He would accept the hukam of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala completely. And he would have this type of yaqeen all the time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching. أَوَلَمْ يَكْفِ بِرَبِّكَ أَنَّهُ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ شَهِيدٍ. Is that not sufficient that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching? Is it not sufficient for you? Allah ta'ala is hazir and nadir. So Allah ta'ala says, يَا أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسُ الْمُطْمَئِنَّةِ. Oh, the contented soul, return happily, well pleased to your Rabb while he is pleased with you. You know, this nisbat is and this connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so amazing and tremendous. On one occasion when we went to Canada, Abdullah said to the people there, you know, people come here to Canada and they all go and see this some type of famous thing, etc. And he started questioning about that to understand what is it about, etc. And this ordinary simpleton, how we would actually say, maybe even an ignorant person, jahil person, what is he saying? No, don't go. Nur bujh jayegi. Don't go, don't go. Your nur would get extinguished. Here, one of the areas here, Itala, we went, myself and Hazrat Maulana Muhammad Ahmad Sahab, Hazrat Wala is saying, and when we reached the place and Hazrat looked at the venue and he understood and he calculated and he summed up everything and he said, listen, I made parhez and I was cautious of not going to such places in my entire life. I've come to the end of my life and I wish to continue on this which I had established. Nevertheless, you may go if you wish. I mean, he was so severe and strict in this particular regard, absolutely. In fact, even his near and dear ones, rather his own children. You know, Hazrat Shaykh al-Hadith writes and he says that this nisbat, to get it, this grand connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, may be sometimes simple, but to lose it, to gain it, it's simple, but to keep it, to maintain it, is difficult. It is difficult. Khune dil peene ko, lakhte jigar khane ko, yahi ghiza milti hai, jana teri diwane ko. You have to go under some type of sacrifice. You have to do some type of mujahada. And this would actually be the nourishment of those who are madly in love with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah ta'ala create some type of fikr and concern within us that we look after and we make hifazat of this nisbat. Shaykh al-Hadith goes on to say that kam ra'ayna shuyukhan saqatu, how many of the shuyukh and the mashayikh we have seen them falling from this position, meaning they got the nisbat, everything, and after that everything was lost. You know, in this path, I'll tell you three type of terminologies. One is wukuf. A person is in this path and then he's not moving forward. He's just stationary. And one is even worse than that, is ruju. Not even stationary, but loses everything. Not even lose everything, complete deterioration. Going backwards. And the last one is that of suluk, chalna. So wukuf, ruk jana, ruju, piche chale jana, and suluk is chalna. You're on this path and you are walking. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is speaking about this nafs. And Allah ta'ala is speaking about this contented soul. And Allah ta'ala says, فَدْخُلِي فِي عِبَادِي وَدْخُلِي جَنَّتِي, that listen, in this dunya, you were pleased with my ahkam. Come, today I am pleased with you. Why are you wasting time here? Go, enter into my servants. Enter among my chosen bondsmen. Mawlana Hakim Akhtar Sahab, Hazarwala, goes on to quote him and says that he would speak abundantly about this and he would establish from this particular ayat that from this, the fazilat, the virtue and the merit of suhbat is established. That even at the time of death, a person is told about going to enter into the chosen servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and going to meet them. And what can we say? Somebody has the desire to meet Abu Bakr. And somebody has the desire to meet Imam Shafi. Hazrat Maulana Shah Wasiullah Sahab used to say that at least one time in the 24 hours, ask Allah for Jannah. Even Jannat will become pleased and he would say to Allah, this person is desirous of me, enter him into me. You know, here people go onto the rickshaw and you understand it, two people can sit on the rickshaw. But sometimes what would happen is that three people would sit onto the rickshaw and then from the distance you say, oh no, what's happening here? The police are there at the main intersection. So already from the distance, one of them jumps off. But the policeman is vigilant. He's watching. He's got his eye on you. Nevertheless, the one starts walking as if he knows nothing about the people of the rickshaw. And the people of the rickshaw tells him, let us pass over. And when we pass over, a good few meters later, then you jump on. The policeman understands all of this. You pass him. He doesn't say a word because he understands that you were considerate about the law and you have some importance attached in your heart towards the law. And then, how much more should we not be considerate about the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? حُفَّتِ الْجَنَّةِ بِالْمَكَارِهِ وَحُفَّتِ النَّارِ بِالشَّهَوَاتِ, that Jannah has been surrounded by difficulties with things which are against our nafs, which we do not want to do. وَحُفَّتِ النَّارِ بِالشَّهَوَاتِ, and Jahannam has been surrounded by passions and desires and lust, something that we want to do. And by doing that, I mean, we would enter into Jannah. And By carrying out that which we do not actually want to do, it's hard on our nafs, we actually gain entry into Jannah and Paradise. So this nisbat, looking after this nisbat, aasa ke ghair mere khana e dil mein kaise? How can an outsider come into my heart when the thought of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala itself is my guard there at the front door of my heart? وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ وَنَعْلَمُ مَا تُوَسْوِسُ بِهِ نَفْسُ. We have created insan and we know very well what his mind and his heart is even thinking and talking about, echoing. You know, Hazrat Tanvi rahimahullah used to say that if I have to go to 100 doors in the search of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I would have went. Thereafter, Hazrat Wala goes on to say, what can I tell you about Hazrat Tanvi? The amount of doors and the amount of mashayikh that he went to go and sit and learn at their feet. You know, when the first time I went to Hazrat Maulana Ali Miyah Sahab, his impression was what? That people did not understand the matlab of Hazrat. And he would go on to say that wahdat matlab, they did not understand the matlab, the meaning of wahdat matlab, that this is my sheikh and he is for my islah and reformation. They did not even understand that fully. You know, Maulana Abrar al-Haq, from amongst the distinguished disciples of Hazrat Tanvi rahimahullah, on one occasion, he said to us specifically, referring that how come these people did not come? That, what was it? It was some type of a tribalism? What was it that they did not attend? I mean, they could not even come to greet. Nevertheless, he was pointing out and teaching us something. But today, Hazrat Wala goes on to say, there's only shakhsiyat, that each person thinks himself to be that personality. So, I mean, so where would he go? Where would he go and learn? And who would he go and meet? Etc. So, he would go on to say that wo khush kismat aadmi jiske andar asabiyat nahi. That man is fortunate indeed who does not have the trait of tribalism in him. That he's prepared to go out. He will sit under this one and that one, and he will learn from them. He will look and he will learn. The hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam goes on to say, Allahumma ardina warda anna. Oh Allah, please us. You please us. You make us pleased with your ahkam. Whatever you had made us mukallaf in this dunya, wa taqdeer, whatever it was. Warda anna, and you also be pleased with us. Now look at that. Look at this dua. We do not put our trust in this, that and the other. It is directly to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another dua is that of Allahumma kun lana waj'alna lak. Oh Allah, you become ours and make us yours. You know, this dua I actually learned from Hakim Nannumiya of Gangor. What can I say? All these people are my muslih. Wherever I went, somebody told me something. Somebody told me to read this, to do that, to do that. Other, and he quotes and he writes that Hazrat Tanvi rahimahullah, whenever he would read this dua, he would become completely satisfied and contented. What can I say about tell you about myself? Hazrat Wala goes on to say, my shuyukh, Hazrat Maulana Shah Wasiullah sahab, Maulana Muhammad Ahmad sahab, Maulana Abrar al-Haq sahab, Maulana Ali Miyah sahab, Maulana Habibur Rahman Azmi sahab. So, when you have become happily well pleased with your Rabb, then Allah Ta'ala becomes well pleased with you. This station and this maqam of Rizā is very, very high. It is a very great station. What I'll tell you about Sayyidina Rifai, Sayyidina Ahmad Rifai rahimahullah, he said that people were waiting in these long, long lines, all to enter the grand court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But all these lines that they were piling up in and gathering were the lines and queues of ibadat and ta'at. And then he said, let me go to that door of ajz, ajizi, inkisari, helplessness, humility, the expression of helplessness in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, I went through that door, there was no one. I entered, there was no queue, no problem, because that is something that is not found in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But rather, it is that which insan needs to adopt. Okay, so let's continue with the kitab. So in this ayat here, we learn that in this dunya as well, the kitab, Shaykh Iskandari rahimahullah is going to say that in the dunya, it is the jannat of obedience. That is also something else. This dunya is the jannat of obedience. That when you obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this dunya is a meaning that is jannat on its own. And the mashur and the famous jannah, we all know about that, and that is in the akhirat. Okay. Hazrat Wala goes on to say, and he says that when a person is hungry, the amount of humility that comes to him is unexplainable. In fact, all that ananiyat and pride and everything goes away. So much so that a person will bow down and even ask for something as simple as roti. What can I tell you about the incident of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam when he gave the flock of the daughters of Musa Shu'aib alayhi salatu wasalam water to drink for the animals? And when he finishes with all of that, he doesn't even ask them for anything. Rather, he asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ثم تولى إلى الظل. I mean, he turns and he goes and he makes his direction and his way towards that of the shade. It also shows us that he did not go and stand in the sun. And on the riwayat of Ali radiallahu ta'ala an, Musa alayhi salatu wasalam at that point actually turns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for roti and bread. Look at the surah of the Quran where Allah Ta'ala says, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ اللَّهُ الصَّمَدْ لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدْ. In this particular surah, Allah Ta'ala is saying, say, He Allah is one. And then Allah says, Allah is independent. Now these two particular sentences are stating and speaking about the qualities of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, which are a confirmation, thubuti, ithbati, and thereafter, lam yalid, one, walam yulad, two, and the third one, walam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad, he has no children, he is not anyone's child, number two, and number three, there is none equal to him. So in this particular surah, we find three ithbati qualities of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah is like this, two ithbati. Allah is like this and like that. And the other three are salbi qualities, meaning, and Allah is not like this, and Allah is not like that, and Allah is not like that, in the description of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, this kitab of mine that I am making so much of mehnat on, years have passed. It's a translation of, Ma'inum min ash-shama'il. And one of the specialities of this particular kitab is the author speaks so much about the salbi qualities that the individual, whether it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, in describing them, that they are not like this and not like that and not like that. Just to give you an example, humility is a thubuti quality, and not to have pride is the salbi description quality. Qana'at and contentment is thubuti, confirmation, and not to have greed is the salbi. The last portion of it, Mawli Abdul Quddus from Africa, South Africa, is busy doing the translation of that. You know, Marana Abrar al-Haq, when he used to make his way on a journey, he would carry this earthen pot, was it? Or was it that flask or jug in which he used to keep his water? And people would say, oh, there's Maulana, he's going with his water and he's taking this and he's taking that. But Maulana himself used to say, see these people, right? They are going to come to me to ask for water. And exactly that would happen. That as the journey would go, they would all be coming to Maulana, Maulana, some water please. Maulana, some water, please. I'll give you the incident which Maulana Muhammad Ahmad Sahab used to quote abundantly. The incident of Akbar Badshah, Akbar the king. I mean, he's the king, but he goes on hunting on one occasion and he's in the wilderness, in the bunduz, and in the open, in the jungles. And now he's absolutely thirsty and hungry, and he finds this hut in which this person gives him some water to drink or maybe some food, whatever it was. And after finishing that, ordinary simple Bedouin, a nomad in the jungles, he says to him, listen, you must come to my palace. You must come and meet me. Nevertheless, this person on one occasion comes, and when he describes himself to the ministers or to the guards, they allow him in. Rather, they even recognize him. He explains what's his situation. He says, and I've come to meet the king. When he's brought in and ushered into the court, he finds Akbar himself. I mean, the halat of Akbar are different. I mean, I'll tell you, at this time here, this was his halat, that he was in sajda. So he said, listen, what is he doing? So they said to him, no, he's asking someone very great, meaning referring to Allah. They're trying to explain to this Bedouin and the nomad, this villager, that he's asking. So he says that, is that the case? Now look at this here. He doesn't even meet Akbar Badshah. He turns away and he walks. And he says, if that's the case, then why do not, if he's asking someone greater, then why don't I ask that being myself? Allahu Akbar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with the wealth of Tawheed. Wahidullah. Fa'inna Tawheed ra'su ta'at. Proclaim the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Tawheed is the head of all different acts of obedience, all ta'at, all goodness. Whatever you do, do whatever you have to do. But if there's no Tawheed and oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there's nothing. Allah bless us with the wealth of Tawheed, the noor of Risalat, and Allah put our hearts at peace and rest with the grand connection, this nisbat and connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now let's make dua. Rabbana la tuzigh qulubana ba'da idh hadaytana wa hab lana min ladunka rahma innaka antal wahhab. Allahumma inna nas'aluka nafsan bika mutma'inna. Oh Allah, we ask you for the contented soul. Tu'minu bi liqa'ik. And look at how beautiful this dua is. We're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for nafs mutma'inna. In the very same dua, in this very same hadith of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this dua, he's actually telling us what's the three requisites of the nafs mutma'inna, the three special characteristics and features of nafs mutma'inna. One is that nafs wants to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, has iman in liqa, in meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that I'm going to meet Allah. Tu'minu bi liqa'ik wa tarda bi qada'ik. And this nafs is always happy with your decision, with your qada, with your taqdeer. Wa taqna'u bi ata'ik. And it is contented with your gift and bestowal. Whatever you give, this nafs is pleased with it. Nevertheless, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather us all in Jannah. Allah ta'ala let us be privileged with the shafa'at of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with the barakat of this great month, the month of Rabi'ul Awwal. You know, as in saying all of that, some type of ta'leem of the seerah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Oh Allah, you become ours and make us yours. Kun lana waj'alna lak. Rabbana taqabbal minna innaka anta samiul alim. Wa tub alayna innaka anta tawwabur rahim. Bi hurmati sayyidin nabiyyil kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.